as a kid. All a nigga wanna have was a Burberry scarf and $3 in my pocket. Instead I got beat with a switch, but I don't give a fuck, but it's on my body. Scars all up on me, but I run around from everybody. Life lesson learned, I better learn from this bitch, nobody. She pushed me around, she didn't give no motherfucks about it. She broke my heart three times, but
Thursday night football, we have the New York Giants taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, unless you are a Giants fan or Eagles fan, you're probably not going to have a lot of interest in turning on and watching this game. And why should you? Because both of these two teams have pretty much been terrible so far this season. The New York Giants are 1-5, coming off their first win of the season against the Washington football team, 20-19. And the Philadelphia Eagles are coming into this game 1-4-1 after losing to the Baltimore Ravens. So, I mean, this is once again another Thursday night football matchup that really isn't going to have a lot of interest and a lot of hype going in. And I mean, it's really rare to find a good Thursday night game that's worth watching. Like, we were blessed to get the Chicago Bears taking on Tampa Bay Buccaneers. But, I mean, now we have to go back and watch the Giants play the Philadelphia Eagles. And, I mean, I have to watch this game because it's basically my job. It's what I get paid to do is watch football and talk about it. But, I mean, this game isn't really a game that I'm all that hyped up about because, I mean, I guess you can say this is a big game for both of these two teams because when you're in this division, the NFC East, I mean, if one of these two teams are able to get the victory, then they put themselves in a really good spot of winning this division because, I mean, the Dallas Cowboys got clobbered by the Arizona Cardinals. So, I mean, this division is still wide open. So, I mean, when you look at the New York Giants have played fairly well over the last 2-3 weeks. And I know a lot of you guys will be like, oh, JT, they played well. I mean, why do they only have one win? Well, I mean, they only have one win. But, I mean, this is a New York Giants football team that has slightly improved. Now, my biggest concern going in is, can this New York Giants offense get going? Now, last week, they defeated Washington. Their offense had a pretty solid performance. That game versus Washington was pretty much the second best offensive performance that the New York Giants have had this season. Their best performance was against the Dallas Cowboys. So other than that, I mean, they haven't really had a lot of good games offensively. And I mean, for the New York Giants, I mean, Daniel Jones really has to get going, man. I mean, like, Daniel Jones has really disappointed me so far this season because I had a lot of high expectations for Daniel Jones going into the season. I don't know if a lot of you guys had any high hopes for Daniel Jones, but I certainly did. And the reason why is because he has Jason Garrett as his offensive coordinator. Now, I know what a lot of you guys are about to say about Jason Garrett. Oh, JT, Jason Garrett sucked as the head coach for the Dallas Cowboys. Why are you surprised that the New York Giants offense is so bad? And I am surprised because, listen, a lot of you guys pretty much don't know this, but Jason Garrett, before he was the head coach of the Dallas Cowboys, actually was regarded as one of the best offensive coordinators in the NFL. A lot of you guys probably don't know that because you guys are pretty much familiar with Jason Garrett's time as the head coach of Dallas, but he was actually one of the best offensive coordinators in the NFL at one time. And when the New York Giants hired him, I mean, I thought this would be a good hire to get the most out of Daniel Jones because, I mean, Jason Garrett did get a good amount of, you know, out of Dak Prescott. Tony Romo was pretty good under Jason Garrett. So, I mean, Jason Garrett does have a knack of working with quarterbacks, but, I mean, Daniel Jones so far hasn't really looked all that impressive. I mean, he's turned the football over. He's like the second coming of Jameis Winston without the arm strength. And I mean, the thing with Daniel Jones is just that he just doesn't feel pressure. It's like he's not scared of pressure. But I mean, I think him not being scared of pressure is a downfall because he just doesn't sense it. So I mean, most of the time he's taking unnecessary sacks, doesn't know when to get rid of the football, holds onto the ball too long. And that's why we see Daniel Jones coughing the football up so much. So I mean, can the New York Giants offense get going? And the way to get this offense going is by maybe trying to ease Daniel Jones into this game, give him some short intermediate passes, maybe try to run the football. But I mean, that's easier said than done because the New York Giants offensive line hasn't really played great this year. I mean, they haven't really been great in pass protection. They haven't really been great in run blocking either. So I mean, this Giants offense, I mean, you had a really good game against Washington that pretty much is your second best performance that you had this season on offense besides when you played the Dallas Cowboys a couple of weeks ago. So I mean, can this Giants offense get going? Now, for the Philadelphia Eagles, you're now starting to get back a little bit healthy because it seems like every time the Philadelphia Eagles take 5 steps forward, they take 5 steps back. So You have the potential of Alshon Jeffrey and DeSean Jackson being able to play in this game, but Zach Ertz and Miles Sanders are not expected to play in this game. So like I said, every time Philadelphia takes five steps forward, they take five steps backwards. Now, I'm taking it that DeSean Jackson is probably going to play in this game because I've been reading a lot of articles saying that there's a lot of confidence that DeSean Jackson will play in this game. And that votes well for Carson Wentz because Carson Wentz, he started the season out a little bit slow, but he has kind of turned it on the last couple of weeks. Now, I want to see what this Eagles offense does without Miles Sanders, because Miles Sanders has been the focal point of this Philadelphia Eagles offense, and now he's not going to be playing. So I want to see what Philadelphia is going to do, because when Miles Sanders was in before he suffered that injury, I mean, this Philadelphia Eagles offense showed they had a little bit of a pulse. You also have rookie wide receiver Travis Fulgham, who has been the best wide receiver on the Philadelphia Eagles roster. So I mean, without Miles Sanders, I want to see what this Eagles offense is going to be able to do. So I'm taking it without Miles Sanders, you're pretty much going to have to heavily rely on the passing game. And I mean, that's something that if you're an Eagles fan, you should have a good amount of confidence in, because there is potential of Alshon Jeffrey and DeSean Jackson playing in this game. So you potentially could have those two guys back with also rookies on Fulgham. So I mean, your offense looks a way better than what it has looked the last couple of weeks in the passing game. So Carson Wentz is actually going to have some reliable targets to throw to. Now, how long will these guys be able to stay healthy? That is to be decided. So I mean, for the Giants, can they score inside the red zone? Because the New York Giants offense has been pretty terrible inside the red zone. I mean, just poor execution and also red zone turnovers. Like, Daniel Jones scoffs the football up a lot in the red zone. I noticed this. And I mean, when you're in the red zone, it's really hard to score if you can't run the football. If you can't run the football in the red zone, then you're going to be in a lot of trouble, because in the red zone, it's a lot harder to throw the football in the red zone because everything is short and the field is short. Like, the spaces are so tightly congested, it's a lot of traffic, so it's really hard to throw the ball in the red zone, which is why I think it's really important for the New York Giants to get this run game going. The Giants are 31st in red zone offense, only scoring touchdowns in the red zone 25%, one of the lowest in the NFL. The Eagles, I mean, they don't have a great red zone defense, so maybe the New York Giants can take advantage of that, because the Philadelphia Eagles are allowing their opponents to score in the red zone 72% of the time, which happens to be 27th in the NFL. So, I mean, the New York Giants have a pretty favorable matchup in terms of red zone defense with how poorly their offense has played in the red zone. Maybe they can be able to take advantage of it. So, I'm going to take Philadelphia to win this game. I think Philadelphia is the far better team in this matchup. And, I mean, I think New York has a pretty good chance of winning this game. But I think with the Philadelphia Eagles potentially getting DeSean Jackson and Alshon Jeffrey back, that should help this offense. And you look at the New York Giants team that can't take care of the football. Like, I just don't trust Daniel Jones. He turns the football over way too much. I don't know if Philadelphia is going to be able to run the football without Miles Sanders playing in this game. So, I mean, even though the Philadelphia Eagles aren't going to have Miles Sanders, I still think they should have a pretty successful day throwing the football on this New York Giants secondary. So I'm going to take the Eagles to win 27-17 is my final score prediction in this game. Give me the Eagles.